Hello all, this is Dr. Alsup, and in this video, we will be discussing the cubital fossa. So we will start with understanding where the cubital fossa is even located, and then we'll delve into understanding the organization of the relatively large neurovasculature within this fossa. So let's start with where the cubital fossa is located, and I want you to look down at the anterior or the front portion of your own elbow region. So think about where your elbow is and then look at the anterior portion, and you'll likely notice a depression on this anterior aspect of the elbow. And this is the cubital fossa region. The boundaries of this region include muscles. In particular, medially, the common flexor tendon of the flexor muscles, where they attach to the medial epicondyle, will form the more medial border. And then laterally, the common extensor tendon, and then some of those muscles that extend a bit more proximally of the extensor or posterior compartment, will attach to the lateral epicondyle or right above and will form the lateral boundary. So it's really more muscles of the forearm and their proximal attachments that are forming these boundaries. So those expansions under the skin are formed by muscles and their tendons, and that's what kind of forms the bumps that cause the depression of the cubital fossa. Deep to the skin, and also importantly within that subcutaneous tissue, so before we've gotten to the deep fascia, you get to a grouping of vasculature in the cubital fossa region. We discussed these veins in the first MSK session, so hopefully you recall that the cephalic vein and basilic veins are the major superficial veins of the upper limb. The basilic vein is more medially placed, whereas the cephalic vein is going to be more laterally placed. And both of these will run through this cubital fossa region, which is right in this middle portion here, around this dashed line. Additionally, there is almost always some form of shunting or communicating vein that will connect these two major veins, the basilic and the cephalic. And that vein is often located in the superficial region of the cubital fossa. The one that's most typically discussed and is usually said to be the most typical presentation is a median cubital vein. So you can see it kind of running across transversely, right across the cubital fossa region, connecting the basilic and the cephalic. Due to the prominence and relative ease of accessibility, the cubital fossa is a common site of venipuncture, so for sampling or transfusion of blood or intravenous injections. And that median cubital vein and most superficial veins lie directly on the deep fascia and the bicipital aponeurosis that we'll discuss more in a moment. And this will help prevent a needle from going deeper than the superficial region, say to a deeper artery. So just remember that this is a common area in terms of any type of procedure like that, but there is considerable variation regarding the veins other than the basilic and the cephalic, and really any superficial vein can be used for this. Moving to the intermediate portion of the cubital fossa, and this is majorly composed of the biceps brachii tendon. Now, this tendon can be easily palpated as it descends distally on its way to attach to the radial tuberosity of the radius. It will send a flat, so you have the tendon, there's a rope-like tendon that's going to play a role, but it will also send a flattened band of tendon called an aponeurosis. More specifically, it's referred to as the bicipital aponeurosis. And it will span most of the cubital fossa just deep to the superficial veins. So in this illustration, it's been reduced a little bit in order to show some of these deeper structures. But if you look at an actual dissection here, you see that it kind of extends over this entire region right here. So here's your biceps brachii, actual muscle belly. The tendon will be descending into this region, and right here is that bicipital aponeurosis, that flattened portion of tendon that expands over this region. This aponeurosis serves as an additional layer of protection for the deeper neurovascular structures of the cubital fossa. And again, as mentioned previously, it importantly serves as a barrier during venipuncture of a needle moving too deep and reaching, say, the large brachial artery that runs deep in this region. So you can usually kind of stops a needle or kind of slow down a needle once you reach this region. Lastly, let's discuss the deep structures in the cubital fossa. And it is here that we are getting some of the largest neurovasculature in the upper limb. Of note, while the stars of the show are those neurovascular structures, there's also a notable amount of adipose tissue that is protecting this region and filling in the kind of quote empty spaces in this region. The terminal portion of the brachial artery is located in the superior portions of the cubital fossa. Recall that the brachial artery is the major artery of the arm. And within the cubital fossa, it will divide into its terminal branches, the ulnar artery and the radial artery. These arteries and their branches will supply the forearm and the hand. The median nerve is located either just deep to the brachial artery or just medial to the brachial artery, like we have here in this illustration, and it will continue past the cubital fossa in order to innervate the majority of the anterior compartment of the forearm, as well as portions of the hand. One thing I do want to note, the radial nerve is located along the lateral border of the cubital fossa, typically deep to those extensor muscles that I told you were forming the boundary of the cubital fossa. And so it will not be visible without retraction of these muscles, but did want to mention its presence deep to this region as well. Most excellent. So that is the cubital fossa, a really packed and interesting, but relatively small space anterior to the elbow joint. Please take time to review the summary slide with the big picture concepts, and as always, reach out with any questions you may have. Please have an excellent rest of your day.